In fact, I'm probably the most prolific person that actually takes the time to act as a consumer advocate, because let's face it, here's the problem with the RV nomad genre on YouTube. The problem with the whole YouTube RV van life, RV people, is that there's a lot of people that are felons, a lot of people that are fake, a lot of people that are just looking for you to pay for their lifestyle because they did not prepare for their life on the road. And then once you go down that rabbit hole, you soon discover that you're paying for their lifestyle. And you discover that, wow, these people got more money than you do, but they want you to pay for their lifestyle. A broken transmission, or they need a new RV, they want you to pay for it. It's crazy. And that's the problem. Everybody wants you to pay for their problems, their lifestyle, even their tax obligations. Because let's face it, a lot of these YouTubers, I really seriously question on how many of them are actually paying all their taxes that are due. But here's the problem. There's fakery. There's fake hiking. There's fake calamities. You know, people pretend that their RV broke down when it didn't, and they want you to pay for a repair. It's crazy. It's sick. Between the disability fraud that many of these RV nomads do, it's pathetic. I really don't want to be associated with the felons and the future felons. We know of, not personally, but know of, deadbeat dads that are RV nomads, felons that are RV nomads. There's even people that live in vans that make so much money and pretend to be poor when in fact they're not poor. That's the whole paradox. People are pretending to be something they're not. This fake narrative that she was going to live in an old RV, give up the six figures a year with all the benefits, just to be a nomad and rely on the kindness of others. Nobody does that, folks. It's not real. She wasn't that successful. Nobody does that. Nobody does that. It's ridiculous. In reality, people of integrity really don't want anything to do with e-beggers, felons, disability fraudsters, and all that entire ilk of people. Stop, folks. Stop. Just really, I'm an adult. I'm a big boy. I'm a big girl. I can look after myself. Please don't send me money, and please don't send other people money. They don't say this. I'm the only person that does this. And trust me, I went on YouTube years ago. I used to get one view a day. Now I've got millions and millions of views. I really don't care. One's proud of that, but I am really proud of warning other people to not send money to these goddamn RV nomads and van dwellers, because they are adults, they can look after themselves. And so in the end, a lot of these people are going to get in trouble for probably tax evasion. Some of them will probably go to jail for disability fraud, because you see these people, they're on disability, but they're quite able-bodied physically. It's crazy. It's sad that people have to resort to that. I'm ashamed to be part of that culture. I'm ashamed to be part of that community, so I will be leaving that community because I'm tired of it. I'm tired of them. I don't want to be associated with e-beggar scam artists and disability fraudsters and felons and the whole nine yards of all of it. I'm tired of it. So tired. It's ridiculous. So if you have any comments about what I've said, put them down below.